Hi, I'm Cindy Clarke, and I'm the clay teacher. But everybody knows me as Mrs. Clay. With Mrs. Clay and Clay, it's Clay Day. Every day is Clay Day! Before we start making our project, we have to learn the rules. Now there's three very important rules that you have to follow when you're working with clay. Rule number one is the most important rule of all. But sometimes rule number one can be the most difficult rule of all. You want to know the most difficult but the most important rule of all when you're working with clay? Are you ready for this one? It's have fun. But what if you're making your something out of clay and you don't like it? Some people will feel frustrated, some people will feel angry, some people want to quit. Well, that's no fun. Just decide what it is that you don't like about your project, go back and watch your video, and then change it. If you don't like something, simply change it. So rule number two is fun to say because it is a part of the rules. Anytime you're forming clay or moving clay, you always want to roll on the table. Roll on the table with your hand big and flat and open, and make sure it goes all the way around and all the way around. Now there's guidelines to rule number two. You can use your hands. But when it's the shape you like, you always want to roll on the table and work on the paper. That is fun to say. So rule number two is roll on the table and work on the paper. Roll on the table, work on the paper. If you don't work on the paper, what's going to happen is it's going to stick to the table. You'll have to scrape it off with your fingertips and start all over. And that's no fun. Now rule number three is more fun to say than rule number two. We're going to want to build our project. We're going to have to glue pieces together in order to build our project. And I use the word glue because that's just what we have to make. Anytime you're making a project, you have little pieces of clay that you're going to want to glue on. So in order to make glue, you have to wet your finger and wiggle your finger. And look what happens when you wet and wiggle your finger. You get this shiny mud. This shiny mud is called slip, and slip works just like glue. Now, isn't slip a funny word for glue, but that's just what it is. Wet your finger, wiggle your finger, make your glue, twist the clay into that glue, and you'll feel it stick. So you wet your finger, twist the clay into that glue, and you'll feel it stick. Now, there's an easy and fun way to say rule number three, is we're going to wet and wiggle and twist and stick. That is fun. Wet and wiggle and twist and stick. A wet and wiggle and twist and stick. Wet and wiggle and twist and stick. You know what happens if we don't wet and wiggle and twist and stick? What's going to happen is when your piece is dry, they're all going to fall off. And that's no fun. So now we know the rules of working with clay. Let's get started. Hi, today we're going to make a Big Mouth Beaver. I call him a Big Mouth Beaver because he has a big mouth. Our kit comes with enough clay to make two Big Mouth Beavers. So I'm going to cut this in half with my standing up slicing toothpick right down the middle, keeping my finger close to the clay as I pass through, going a little bit deeper each time. When I'm almost through, I can just break it in half. I can put this in the bag and I can use it another time. Seal it in your bag and then put your bag and keep it in your bucket. Okay, now to make our beaver, we're going to divide this piece of clay into three separate pieces. At the end of our fingertips, we all have chompers, and they're going to chomp through that clay. They can chomp through by themselves, or they can chomp through together, and they can just chomp and turn and separate our clay into three equal pieces. Yeah, kind of equal. I'm going to pick one to be the platform of the pancake, and the other two are going to wait to be turned into something else in a damp cloth. I like to keep my clay in a damp cloth so it's always nice and fresh and soft and ready to use. We're going to turn this messy ball of clay into a tidy ball of clay using rule number two. I'm going to roll on the table. My hand is big and flat and open. I'm going to roll around and around until it's tidy. We know there are guidelines to rule number two. You can use your hands. I like to use the table. I'm going to roll on the table, work on the paper, and I'm going to make a tapper. Make my hand into a fist, and I'm going to gently tap this, and it's going to flatten out. Tap and turn, tap and turn, tap and turn, tap and turn. I'm gently tapping and not banging the clay hard. So now I've got my little pancake that's going to be about as thick as your finger. Did you know that everything you make out of clay has to be as thick as your finger? If you're not sure how thick to make your clay, you just tell someone it has to be as thick as your finger. And then if you're still not sure, look at what you're waving at that person. Oh, it's your finger. Put it aside and make sure they're the same. Little pieces of clay like to break. I want to make sure that this little pancake or platform is flat. So I'm just going to push from the middle and out. It makes it nice and flat, and it makes a nice tidy edge. I always like the edges of my pancakes to be tidy. Now we have this, I want to roll it. Again, it makes it nice and tidy. And now it's as thick as my finger. This is the bumpy side. This is a good side to write something down if you want to. I'm going to write my name, Mrs. Clay. You can write your name on your piece of clay. You could write the year. You could write a special message. You can write anything you like. This is your project. I'm going to turn it over and work on the tidy side. Now that's just going to wait to hold the beaver. I'm going to take another piece of clay and I'm going to make a pinch pot. I'm going to roll on the table until it's a tidy ball, or use my hands. I'm going to roll on the table. I'm going to turn this ball of clay into the mouth of this beaver, into a pot that I'm going to turn into a beaver. So I'm going to roll on the table, and when it's tidy, I'm going to tap one side smooth. So now we have a flat bottom and a round top. The hand that does not hold your pencil holds the round side with the flat side out. And the thumb of the hand that does hold your pencil goes right in the middle, and we start to push and turn and push and turn and push and turn until the end of my thumb to the top of the clay is as thick as my finger. I call this a pinch pot because I'm going to pinch it. But when I pinch fingerprints to fingerprints. I ripped my clay apart with fingertips. I form my clay with fingerprints to fingerprints. Now I'm going to pinch and turn and pinch and turn and pinch and turn. And I'm going to pinch and turn until I go all the way around the bottom, keeping my fingers always finger width apart. And I'm going to move it up. So let's just cut this in half so we can see what's going on in here. So my fingers went down, my thumb went down. It's as thick as my finger. Then I pinch and turn and pinch and turn and pinch and turn till the whole thing is as thick as a finger. So let's roll this up and start again. I'm going to roll on the table or roll in my hands. Roll until it's tidy. What I'm going to do is I'm going to tap one side flat. The hand that does not hold my pencil holds the round part. The thumb of the hand that does hold your pencil goes right in the middle and push and turn and push and turn until it's as thick as a finger. And then with this guy is going to pinch and turn and pinch and turn and pinch and turn. And I go all the way around, move up a little bit more and pinch and pinch. But you have to watch this guy. Sometimes this guy is not your friend. Sometimes this guy right here, he pinches too much. He gets overexcited and he'll pinch and pinch and pinch and pinch and pinch and pinch until he has totally ruined your pinch pot. Should we let this guy, who's not your friend, okay, he's your friend, he just gets really, really excited. We have to learn to keep him in check. But should we let him go a little bit crazy and pinch too much to see what could happen if you do? Okay, let's try that. He's going to pinch and turn and pinch and turn and pinch and pinch and pinch and pinch. And look what happens. He just gets overexcited. And what happens to your pinch pot? It gets really big and really thin. And there's nothing you can do about that. Let's start again. Now, your pinch pot or your clay at this point might be getting a little bit dry. If you rolled it up and tried and rolled it up and tried, what happens is the clay can dry out and become very hard to work with. What you can do is take a little bit of water, kind of squish it in a bit. Now with your cloth, We're just going to just squeeze that dry clay a little bit in the cloth, and it's going to take on the water. And that piece of clay again, now we can roll it up, and we don't have to use the clay from the other pinch pot or for the next project, and it's ready to go again. So if it does get too dry in making your pinch pot, just add some more water, squish it in your cloth, and we're ready to go again. So here, now we know how to do this. This guy's in check, and we're going to make a pinch pot, and this time we're going to keep it. We know how to do this now. We're going to roll on the table until it's tidy. Going to tap one side till it's flat. The round side goes in the palm that does not hold our pencil. The thumb of our hand that does goes in the flat part. And we're going to push and turn and push. We're going to now pinch fingerprints to fingerprints, keeping our friend in check. And we're just going to pinch and turn and pinch and turn and pinch and turn, slowly moving our way up so the whole pinch pot is as thick as a finger. Now we're at the top, and you can see it's as thick as a finger. Sometimes what happens is they can get uneven. You can gently tap it. Sometimes they might get kind of dry and wrinkles in it if you've been working with it for a while. One drop of water, I'll say that again, one drop of water and a bunch of finger wiggling will go a long way. A little bit of water goes a very long way. Now we have a tidy, round little pinch pot with a nice flat round top that's as thick as a finger. And I'm going to set it at an angle because we don't want it to be a bowl. We don't want it to be that. We want it to be setting at an angle, kind of looking up in the corner of the room. And I want to make it shaped like a beaver's mouth. Now a beaver has a mouth, well, it's a big rat basically. And I'm just going to squeeze it again with this fingerprints to fingerprints and make that kind of a teardrop shape. Now I'm not going to put him on the pancake right now. He's just going to sit there and he's going to wait. With this little piece of clay, I'm going to nip off a piece of clay about the size of a little plum, a big purple grape, a meatball, about this big. And I'm going to roll it into a cone. To roll a cone, we're going to roll it tidy a little bit, roll it into a cylinder. Let's move him over there. Roll it into a little cylinder. And then to make it a cone, the hand that holds the pencil, its little finger, is going to stay close to the table. And the same hand, its index finger, is going to go up and it's going to make an angle. And if I roll that angle over that cylinder, the side that I roll is going to get small. And now we're going to have a little cone. Don't let your cone get really long. It's going to be a short, fat beaver tail. Roll on the table, work on the paper, and tap out that piece of clay until, you guessed it, it's as thick as a finger. Now this is a good shape for a beaver tail. You can make it a little bit wider, a little bit tidier. There's no rules on how big a big mouth beaver tail is supposed to be. But I'm going to put it here, and then I'm going to put this here, and you can see there's an overlap. So where it overlaps, I'm just going to cut that off. Just like that. Now it's going to fit. So I want it to stay on. So I'm going to wet and wiggle. Now we all know rule number three is wet and wiggle and twist and stick. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to change it just a little bit like I always do when I add big pieces together. I'm going to do two wets, wet and wiggle, 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 wiggle. Now I didn't say wet and wet and wet and wet. If you get it really wet, it's going to turn into a mud puddle, which isn't very nice. So we're going to just wet and wet. And then wiggle, 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 wiggle. And look at all that mud I have to join the beaver on. I'm going to twist it so he's on the pancake. And twist and stick. And twist the tail so he's on the pancake. And now we have the mouth and the beaver on the pancake. But you can see where his tail joins on. And you can't see on anybody where their parts join on. You look at a dog or a beaver, you can't tell where the tail joins on. This little piece of clay that you cut off to make them fit, we're going to roll it into a little coil. Now I'm rolling back and forth. You can roll it forward, bring it back. But I'm just going to make a little coil of clay. And I'm going to put it in here, wet and wiggle. And it's going to blend those pieces together. If it's too long, make it shorter. This one fits. But I want to smear the clay into the tail and smear the clay into the beaver's body. So I have to use a dry finger. You always blend or smear or move the clay with a dry finger. If you try a wet finger, it just goes all slidey and it won't move. So I've taken half of that coil into the tail, the other half of that coil up into the beaver's body. And now it's all tidy. Now I'm not going to decorate the beaver's tail right now because I'm going to be touching this guy quite a bit. And if you put the decorations on the beaver tail on now, chances are you'll just make them all messy. So we'll do that last. So we have our beaver now with his tail, his little rat face. I want to make his face first. I always like to make the face of anyone I'm working with. We have our clay waiting in the cloth. Take a little piece of clay and I'm going to make two little eyes. Beavers are big rodents and they have little beady rat eyes. We won't tell them, but we know they do. So we're going to make two little pieces of clay. I like to make them the same size before I put them on. It's really hard to change their size once you have them on. And we want to make sure they're the same size. Our beaver doesn't want to go through life like this with one little eye and one big eye. All the rest of the beavers in the pond would just laugh at him and he would be very sad. So I'm going to make two little balls of clay the same size. We don't want his eyes to fall off. Again, he'd be very sad. And if his eyes fell off, what could he cry with? He was sad. I don't know. So we're going to put on one little beady beaver eye and two little beady beaver eyes. So now he has eyes, but if you look at anybody's eyes, we all have the white part of our eyes. And then in the middle of our eyes, we have the colored part. So I'm going to put on another tiny dot of clay. You can do this if you want to. You could just poke him in the eye so he could see. Or if you want to, you can put on another little piece of clay, kind of do the color of his eyes. Little pieces of clay I like to roll on my hand, so I'm just going to wet and wiggle. And little pieces of clay need little wiggles. And twist, or little twists, and twist and stick. So now I'm going to poke him in the eye. Ow. He doesn't mind because after I do that he can see. Now we're going to give our beaver a little nose. And I'm going to roll a little ball of clay and I'm just going to flatten it with my fingertips. I'm just going to pinch it kind of into like a little teardrop or a little triangle. I'm going to put that on, wet and wiggle and twist and stick. We can poke him in the nose. Again, if you poke him in the nose, he doesn't mind because then he can smell things. Make sure his mouth is tidy. What I want to give the beaver next are his legs. Did you know that beavers have legs like snails? Snails don't have legs. Anyway, beavers have legs that are shaped like a snail. So I'm going to get two pieces of clay about the size of a big purple grape. And I want them to be the same size. If I start out with the same size, his legs will be the same size. If one leg is bigger than the other leg, our beaver would swim in circles all over the pond. So we're going to roll on the table and work on the paper. I'm going to tap it into a cookie. When I tap the leg into a cookie, I make sure it's as thick as a cookie. If you tap the beaver's legs till they're really skinny, what's going to happen is little pieces of clay like to break. So that one won't work. So you can just roll it up again, roll on the table, work on the paper and tap it into a little ball of clay for his back legs. Beavers have great big back legs. So I'm going to make another one and let's make sure his legs are the same size. There's a trick to making legs the same size. You can put one over top of the other and the way we rolled his pancake or his platform tidy, we can roll his legs tidy. And when you roll them tidy this way, they'll not only be tidy but they will be the same size. So now we have two legs. I want to make two little beaver paws. So beavers don't have very big feet. Going to roll out one piece of clay. I'm going to roll this piece of clay as fat around as I want it, but twice as long. So when I cut it in half, I have two beaver feet the same size. So cut that in half with my toothpick. And I'm going to drive this foot right on top of those toes. Notice the wet and wiggle and twist and stick. Now he's got great big back leg haunches. I'm going to put one leg on. It's going to touch the beaver here and it's also going to touch on the pancake. It's very important to make sure that you glue under his toes to hold his toes down. So make sure you touch his body, and wiggle under his toes, and make sure those toes are on the pancake and his legs are well attached. Now the next one, I'm going to do the same, wet and wiggle, drive it onto his toes, and we're going to glue this side on, wet and wiggle underneath, making sure it's nailed down, and we're going to put that one on, and we're going to get the toothpick out of the way, twist and stick, making sure his toes are down and in place. Okay, looking down at my beaver, I realized he doesn't have any ears. He doesn't even know I said that. He can't hear a thing. Let's give our beaver some ears. They have little tiny rat ears. So I'm going to make two little balls of clay the same size and just put them on, keeping them round. Be very careful not to let them get skinny. A lot of times what people do when they put the beaver ears on is they squeeze them and they have these little skinny pieces of clay and then they just like to break. So make sure you have your little ball of clay. I'm going to make two balls of clay, just like the eyes, the same time, the same size. Wet and wiggle his ears on just behind his eyes, not letting them get pinched skinny, but letting them just stay round and thick. And blend them in at the back. There, now we can hear me talking about him. Now beavers have little arms on their front. They have little tiny rat arms. So we're going to make a couple little arms coming out of just out the front. There's no really wrong place or right place to put these little legs because it's a big mouth beaver. You can't really tell where the legs are supposed to go. So if you like them there, they're in the right place. I'm going to roll out a coil of clay back and forth, forward and back, whatever way works for me. I'm going to cut it in half with my toothpick. And I've got two little short beaver legs. One goes on this side, one goes on that side. And I'm going to put them on there, just making sure they're close to his body. Now his legs are quite small. If you put his legs out there, it could look really cool, but they'll be fragile and they could break someday. Might take a while, but eventually they would break off. So put his legs touch to his body, and that way they're on there forever. So we're just going to blend them in because you can't tell where anybody's legs join on, beaver or people. And let's give him some toes. He doesn't have toes on his back legs. It's toe time. So toes on his back legs, toes on his front legs. I'm giving cartoon toes, two little prints equals three toes. And you could do three prints to give him four toes. He's your beaver. See, I did four there and three there. You can decide which one you like the best. Now we call this guy a big mouth beaver, so he needs his big tongue. We have in our cloth a ball of clay, so I'm going to nip off a piece of clay about this big. Now we want a tongue to start off a piece of clay about the size of a big purple grape or a little meatball. People often like to give the beavers great big long tongues, and they look kind of silly and they usually break off. So I'm just going to give them a little big tongue, if that makes any sense. We're going to give them a little big tongue, and I'm going to roll into a cylinder. We know how to do this. Roll it into a cylinder, roll on the table. Now your cylinder you want to be about as big as your thumb. So when you put your hand down, it should be about as long as your thumb, from where your thumb leaves your hand to where it ends. My thumb is longer than this piece of clay because it should be as long as your thumb. And if you have little skinny thumbs, it should be about as thick as two thumbs. So it's as long as one thumb, as fat as two thumbs. We have this nice little cylinder. Roll on the table, work on the paper. I'm going to tap it into a flat little cookie and guess how thick it's going to be. It's as thick as your finger. Now this is messy on the end. I don't like it messy. I always like my clay to be tidy. You can just tap it tidy with a dry finger. You always tap it tidy with the dry finger. You can roll it on there. And now I have a nice flattened cylinder into a tongue. I'm going to put the tongue in the beaver's mouth. Make sure it fits. So I'm going to wet and wiggle, making lots of mud, and put it right down his throat. Poor beaver stuck my thumb right down his throat. And then we're just going to tidy that tongue and make sure it hangs down and touches his lip. Now anybody who has a tongue laying out that long is going to have a great big, what I call, line down the middle. So we have to give him a line. So lazy laying down toothpicks. We're going to give him his line. Now toothpicks can work in two ways. When toothpicks are wanting to slice clay and separate that big block of clay that we started with, they are standing up, slicing toothpicks, and they can go right through your clay. But when toothpicks start to decorate, they get very lazy. They want to do lazy laying down toothpick stamps and toothpick marks and toothpick lines. But if they do standing up decorative slices, it's not going to be very nice for your beaver's tongue. So we always want to do lazy laying down toothpick lines for decorating. What a beaver needs now are his big teeth. There's a bit of a trick to the teeth. You just see the teeth in the front. And they look like a piece of clay just stuck up in there. But they're kind of like a capital L with the short part of the tooth showing. And then the other part going right back into the beaver's mouth like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to nip off another little piece of clay. I'm going to roll a little cylinder. That might be a bit too big. And I'm going to fold it over my thumb. I'm not going to squeeze. If you pinch this way, what happens is his teeth get really skinny, and we all know little pieces of clay like to break. So I'm going to just gently fold that over my finger. And this is the part of the teeth that you're going to see sticking out of the beaver, making sure it's tidy. And this part is going to go into the back of the beaver's mouth and down his throat to make sure they stay in there forever. So now he's got his teeth. And I'm going to wet and wiggle this big piece of clay. And there's lots of clay to hang onto those teeth. And with my finger, I'm going to attach it all the way in. And then we can make his teeth fit. That way his teeth won't fall out. If you just put a little piece of clay in there, chances are he'll lose his teeth. And I don't know what would happen to a beaver if he doesn't have his teeth. So we're going to put a lazy laying down toothpick line in his teeth. And now he's just about ready. Going to decorate his tail. Again, lazy laying down texture marks on his tail. I just want to add an angle. Lazy laying down texture marks, an angle that way. I'm not cutting the clay, I'm only marking the clay. So he's just about ready, but I've got clay left. So I could leave him this way and put the clay back in my bag and use it another day, or I could add some fun things to the beaver. I'm going to show you how to make a top hat for your beaver. Not every beaver has a top hat. I'm going to take a little piece of clay, roll on the table, work on the paper, tap it into a cookie. It has to be as thick as somebody's finger. It doesn't have to be as thick as your finger, but it has to be as thick as a cookie. If you tap the beaver's hat brim out like this, it's going to break. Little pieces of clay always like to break. Roll on the table, work on the paper, tap out a cookie, roll it tidy. We know how to do this. And what I'm going to do now is going to nip off another little piece of clay and make a little cylinder. Roll on the table and just make a little cylinder and wet and wiggle and twist and stick. And if I put the little marshmallow on the cookie, we can give him a top hat. Doesn't he look cool in his top hat? So we can do beaver in a top hat. Another fun thing to do is we can give your beaver a funny hairdo. What if we gave him a mohawk? Mohawks are easy to make. Gonna roll out a cylinder, roll on the table, work on the paper, tap it out as thick as a finger. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna curve it round this way. And with the side of my toothpick, I'm gonna draw the hair on it. Because people like to do mohawks and they get little skinny pieces of clay, and we all know little pieces of clay like to break. But if I do it this way, wet and wiggle, then I can give my beaver a funny hairdo. So you can give your beaver a top hat, you can give him a mohawk, you can give him nothing and just put this clay back in your bag and use it another time. Anyway, this beaver is done. I'm going to give him the top hat. This beaver will be done in just a moment. And when he's done, we're going to come back for his project check. His hat's just about done. Wet and wiggle, wet and wiggle, and twist and stick. We're going to come back in a minute and do our project check. Now we're going to do our project check. When I was making the beaver, I put 4 toes on this one and 3 toes on the rest. I think I like 4 toes better. So I'm just going to, with a dry finger, blend that. You can kind of smear it in with your toothpick. And I'm going to give him 3 stamps for 4 toes. and blend those fingers in. And I can change my mind. He's my little beaver. 1, 2, 3 stamps. And on this side, we're going to give him 3 stamps. That way all his toes match. 1, 2, and 3 toes. I noticed, looking at him, his tooth line doesn't go all the way around. Doesn't look like 2 separate teeth. It looks like I drew a line in the clay for some reason. I left a messy bit there. This is kind of a messy line here. So he's got his hands on, his hat is nice and stuck. Do I want his hat to be straight? No, I want his hat off to one side, and it's messy there. So now you can see with the project check, you can go through and make your guy as tidy as you like. I like mine to be tidy. I think he's pretty much done now. So now his project check done, his arms are blended, his toes are perfect, his teeth are separated, and now he's ready for drying. In your kit, there are bags to help you with the drawing. So just gently cover your beaver with the bag and let it sit overnight the day that it's been made. The next day, you can take the bag off and he can go in the air for 4 or 5 hours and dry for a little bit. And then after that, cover him over again with the plastic bag and let it dry again for another night. After 2 nights covered in plastic, he is free to go out in the air and dry naturally. When he's completely dry, he's going to be ready for painting. The beaver now is completely dry. It has gone from dark clay to light clay. If you're not sure if it's dry, just touch it to your face. If it feels really cold, then it's still wet. Give it a few more days. But this one is completely dry and ready for painting. Before I start painting, what I want to do is I want to make sure it's tidy. I always like my projects to be tidy. So I'm going to take my toothpick, and there's little bits of clay here that I don't like. Make sure the pancake or the platform is sitting on, there's no sharp edges. His toes are a little messy, so we're just going to tidy his little toes. His tongue line is defined and clean, but if it wasn't now, I would make it tidy. He's looking pretty tidy. Right there's a messy bit. I don't like that. I'm going to blow off all the little messy bits that I chipped off there. And now it's ready for painting. I'm going to start painting the beaver on the bottom and then working my way up. Your kit comes with 2 brushes. We have a big one for the big areas and a little one for decorating. Taking the big brush, I'm going to just very gently start painting up on the bottom. I'm going to paint the bottom completely. Now these are a nice brush and they do a nice job. And once you have the bottom covered, you're going to paint up the sides. Taking your time to make sure it gets in all the little bumps. There's little bumps there. And making sure your brush covers all those. Make sure, you have to make sure when you're painting the raw clay that it is completely sealed with the acrylic paint. The bottom's now done. And when I start painting the top, you want to make sure that this goes right into every little corner. That every bit of this project is completely covered under there and under there with the acrylic paint. Just sort of get your brush very wet with the paint and then go in all those little nooks and crannies. Now the bottom is covered and I've painted up the sides. It's quite wet, so I'm going to set my beaver upside down over there and the bottom is going to continue to dry and it will go from shiny to not shiny. Now this one is completely painted and it is dry. If you happen to get a few misses on the side where it has stuck to the paper, that's all right. We can just tidy that right up. Now I'm going to start decorating this. And I'm going to start decorating moving out. I want to paint his hat black, but I want to paint his hat black, but I also want to give him black eyes and a black nose. So I'm going to start with the white paint first, because I'm going to paint all of the eye white. Now, when you look at somebody, everybody has the white part of their eye and the colored part in the middle. So I'm going to paint the whole eye white and then give him the color in the middle. That way you can't see where one painting ends and the other one starts. If you do happen to get some paint on him from the white paint, when the white paint's dry, you can just paint him brown again. In painting in layers like this, you can make sure it's all completely covered and all very tidy. I'm going to make sure his teeth are white, because the beaver has big white teeth. And taking your time. And I want to give him a pink tongue. I'm pretty sure if a beaver stuck his tongue out that big, it would be all pink. And there you can, it's a little trick in getting in these edges. Gently with your hand, just sort of just push the brush in there a little bit. If you don't get right to there, no one's going to notice how close it is. Now with the white on the brush, a little bit of water, and into the red, we're just going to give him a pink tongue. Little bit of red, little bit of white. You could mix the pink you want in one of the little containers supplied in your kit, but I'm not going to use that much paint. And if you do have a little bit of messy red, or messy red in the white, or messy white in the red, you can just stir it up and you won't even know it's there. Now to get the color that you want on his tongue, it might take a couple of coats. I'm going to give him this coat now, and I'll decide later if I want to change it. But I'm going to move on to the black. You can just clean your brush in the water, run it on your paper, or you can have a cloth at hand and clean it in the cloth. I'm going to move on to the black. Again, with a wet paintbrush, I'm going to go into the black and get a little bit of black paint. And I don't want his tail completely black, so I'm just going to give it a little bit of black and lots of water. Now here's a little trick, because we don't want to see just a plain black tail on this. It'll just look like it was stuck on. So a little bit of water, just rub it with your finger, and it gives it a natural sort of different color, but not a really dark black tail color. Not the color we're going to give his hat and his toes. I want his hat to be black, so I'm just going to very gently paint his hat black. So I'm going to take my time and I'm going to paint the hat black. And I'm going to paint his toes black. Just gently touch each toe with the black. I'm going to take my time painting the beaver. I'm going to finish off his toes and maybe give his tongue another coat. Make sure his teeth are tidy. And when we come back, his eyes are black, his teeth are tidy, and his toes are tidy, then he'll be ready for sealing. Now the beaver is completely painted and decorated and ready for sealing. I noticed when I finished painting him that I forgot to paint his pancake green. So I, with the paint strips, gave him a nice green platform to sit on. But now he's decorated and his platform is green, I'm going to paint him with the sealant in the kit. Making sure that when you paint with the sealant, you always paint on the paper. If you get the sealant on the table, wipe it off quickly while it's still wet. It could leave a stain. So we're going to go ahead and paint with the sealant, or seal with the sealant, the same way we used the paint, starting on the bottom with a large brush. We don't have to use the small brush this time. Work on the bottom and then start painting up, making sure every surface is completely painted with the sealant. Now I'm just going to use this all at once. I'm going to pretend the bottom is sealed. It has sat turned over and dry. And now I'm going to just make sure that the entire surface of our beaver is completely covered in the sealant, giving it a generous coat from top to bottom. Well, I'm going to continue sealing this little guy here, but when he's finished drying and every piece is covered with the sealer, your beaver is finished. Now our project is finished and our table is tidy. We're going to want to put away all our supplies. Any leftover clay you might have, keep it in the bag it came in and keep it sealed in your bucket. The leftover plastics can be used over and over again. Your toothpicks, if they have clay on them, can be cleaned easily just by rolling them in your hands when they're dry and kept in your bucket. Leftover paint, make sure the lids are closed and put them in your bucket. Your little plastic containers can be used over and over again. But when you wash them, make sure you wash them when the paint or the sealant is wet. They wash up very easily with a little bit of soap and warm water, and keep them in your bucket. Your brushes need a bit more care. When you get your brushes and they're full of paint or sealant, run them under the tap for a little bit to get rid of the big pieces. And then with a little bit of liquid soap in the palm of your hand, just wash them in that soap. Run them back under the tap until they run clean. And then make sure that your brushes are tidy. With your fingertips, just make a nice little tidy edge on that. They can lay down on some paper that you have left over or any other paper and dry laying flat, or you can stand them up on something in the bottom of your bucket, but you want to make sure when your brush is dry that they are tidy and not bent. It's very hard to paint with a bent brush, and tidy's just better. So now our brushes are going to dry in the bucket, and we can put extra paper in the bucket. When the brushes are dry, I'm going to put the lid on, and this is a wonderful craft bucket. Now you have all your stuff in there. It's all very tidy, but it's a great bucket. You can use it forever. This will be your craft bucket. If it gets dirty, just put it in the dishwasher. Yeah, put it in the dishwasher. This is a completely kitchen-safe bucket, dishwasher and microwave safe. Yes, you can even heat your lunch in your bucket. I'm not sure why you want to heat your lunch in your bucket, but make sure you put it in the dishwasher first. So now we have it all put away and our table is tidy. Keep in mind that every day is clay day!